I am so amazed at the working of God. This devotion that I have today was developed 2 weeks ago, and I put it on hold for last week, and it just fits right into what is being discussed this morning. Our God is amazing. He is amazing. Good morning, Joy Gospel Radio FM family. We thank God for another privilege to be able to share a devotion with you. Let us pray. Father, we thank you this morning for your grace and your mercy. We thank you, God, that you remain faithful. We thank you, Lord, that we can trust you in every situation in our lives because you are God. And so we thank you this morning, Father, for being with us. We thank you for your guidance. We thank you, Lord, that you lead us, Lord God. We thank you, Father, that we are obedient to follow you, Lord. Help us to always stay, hallelujah, in obedience with you, mighty God. Bless this devotion this morning to somebody's ears, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. And let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. The title of the devotion this morning is Stay in Position for Your Blessing. Stay in position for your blessing. And I'm reading from Genesis 26, verses 1 to 3. The first part of verse 3, Genesis 26, 1 to 3. There was a famine in the land besides the first famine that was in the days of Abraham. And Isaac went to Abimelech, king of the Philistines in Gerar. Then the Lord appeared to him and said, "Do not go down to Egypt. Live in the land in which I shall tell you. Dwell in this land, and I will be with you and bless you." This morning, I want to say to us, stay in position for your blessing. Isaac was in a land of famine. Nothing was growing. As with any of us with a family, we would want to move to greener pastures. Famine is in the land. Maybe this morning, famine is in your life. You don't see how you will be blessed in this stagnant position as you see it. But God is saying, stay right there. Do not move to another place. I will bless you right there in the midst of the famine. Famine is a state of barrenness, challenges, and difficult situations. When we find ourselves in these circumstances, know that God has you in position to be blessed. However, there are conditions which we must adhere to. First, we must listen to God's instructions. God said to Isaac, "Dwell in the land and I will bless you." Which voice are you listening to this morning? Have you heard the voice of God and now another voice is changing your decision? Listen to God's voice. Listen to his instructions. The first instruction for your blessing is no matter how dry it looks, hallelujah, stay in position. God will bless you right there. If God has told you to stay, then stay. You may be planning to move because of the famine, but God says, stay. Dwell right there. Right there, I will bless you. In order to receive the blessing from God, we must be where God wants us to be, no matter how the situation looks to the natural eye. We cannot look at the situation through our natural eyes. We have to look at our situation in faith, by faith. So no matter how it may look in the natural, no matter how it may look to somebody else, no matter how you may look to somebody else, trust God because he says to stay right there. Number two, we must believe that the time is now. Now faith. Hallelujah. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. You need faith now. So we must believe that the time is now. God told Isaac, dwell in the land. In other words, dwell now. Don't think about the past or be concerned about the future. Now I will bless you right there. We must believe that God will fulfill his word for our lives now. Expect to receive his promises. It may not look so, but live as if God is already blessing you. Hallelujah. It may not look so, but live as if God is already blessing you, because you know in whom you have believed. You know in whom you have put your trust. Hallelujah. So even though it may not look so, live as if he is already blessing you, because he said so. Isaac was obedient to God. He planted in a famine, believing in God's promise. Verse 12 and 13 of that chapter says, then Isaac sowed in that land, in the dry land. Hey, Isaac sowed in that land and reaped in the same year 100-fold, and the Lord blessed him. It may look strange to some people, hallelujah, for what you are doing, but God has commissioned you to do it. So no matter how it might look in the eyes of people, you will do what God says to do. Hallelujah. Sometimes you don't even have to say what you are doing. Just do what God says, because you are not obedient to people. You are obedient to God. The man, verse 13 says, the man began to prosper. Verse 12 says, the Lord blessed him. But look at this. The Lord blessed him. He began to prosper and continued prospering until he became very prosperous. That's how God blesses. God blesses in abundance when we allow him to guide us. We have to plant expecting a harvest. Some people try to make a deal with God and they say, God, if you bless me, then I will give. Doesn't work like that. We give and God blesses. We give in faith and God blesses us. We plant in faith and God blesses us. You may be experiencing a famine right now in your life. There may be some challenges. There may be some barren situations. And you are saying, how will I be able to sow into JGRFM next week? Listen to the voice of God and be obedient to whatever he says. Hallelujah. That is what living by faith is all about. Trusting God even when we don't see the answer. Even though it looks like it's not changing, glory to God, we still trust God because he said so. So we trust him even though there is no change. We trust God because he said he will do it. Number three, you must allow God to move in his way. God bless Isaac the way God wanted to. We can't tell God how to bless us. Of course, we have to be specific in our prayers, but we have to allow God to answer how he chooses to answer. He sees the end from the beginning. We must be flexible in our expectations. Sometimes we expect God to bless us in one way, and we don't even realize that God has already blessed us. Hallelujah. We take his blessing for granted because that's not the way we expected him to work. That's not the way we expected him to bless. That's not what we expected to receive. But look at your blessing. God kept you there because he wants to bless you. We must be flexible in our expectations. Do not box God in. He is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can ask or think. Hallelujah. We are expected to obey God. God is not obligated to obey us. He will answer in his time and in his special way. You must be obedient to God. That's number four. We must be obedient to God. God told Isaac to stay in a land of famine. He could have shown God all the reasons why that could not work, but he chose to obey God. Any of us ever argue with God and say, God, look, you don't see my situation. You're telling me to stay here, but you don't see what's going on around me. We must be obedient to God. Isaac chose to obey God. What God says may seem impossible to us, But God does work in mysterious ways. He had Naaman dip 7 times in the muddy river, even though he had leprosy. He told the people to remove the stone for a dead man to walk out, even though he had been dead for 4 days. He told Joshua to have the people walk around the walls of Jericho and shout, although shouting never caused a wall to fall before. Glory to God. His command may seem irrelevant to you, but your success is guaranteed in him. Our success is guaranteed in God. Isaac reaped 100-fold, began to prosper, continued to prosper, and became very prosperous. God wants to bless us, but we must stay in position to receive. We must listen to God's instructions. We must believe that the time is now. We must allow God to move in his way, and we must be obedient to God. Stay in position for your blessing. Father, we thank you this morning for this devotion that you have given to us. And Lord, I know that you have spoken to somebody this morning who is about to move out of position. Was about to move out of position because it seemed, Lord God, that you couldn't work in that situation. My God. But you will work somewhere else. Father, in the name of Jesus, give direction now. Give instructions now. And Father, cause us to be obedient to you and to your word in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you and we praise you, God. In Jesus' name, amen. The Lord bless you.